So the Petronas Towers up here in Kuala Lumpur, in a way, Jukin and Boaz out of the Bible, at the gates of the house of the Lord. And the Stargate, in a way, between the pillars. With the flag, there is also the sun and moon symbolism, and interestingly, the Stargate, and also interestingly, also the Pyramid of Light through here. Now, just turning around, in a way, more symbolism here regarding the pyramid. This building is in perfect alignment here. So the alignment goes through here. You have the sun window through here with the keystone, and the pyramid is atop this building. Now the alignment, if I do a 180 degree spin here, the alignment carries on to the center, with the sun and moon here on the Malaysian flag, with the Petronas Towers right here, representing the sun and moon, male and female, etc., the pillars of Jukin and Boaz, as described in the Bible. So just under a section of the Petronas Towers here, just notably, you have the Vesica Pisces in here, in a way, the flower of life design coming through here, spiraling out the same up in the ceiling here, where again, giving a hint really as to what these towers are about.
Just for a moment here to tie in with the theme. So from the very beginning of the Bible, in the beginning God created the heaven and the earth, and the earth was without form. So the earth was created but without form. And then it's got here, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. Now the waters, you have reference to the kind of inner waters of the body, in a way, the tree of life within the body. A reference to this might be, he who believes in me, as the scriptures said, from his innermost being will flow rivers of living water. Now also, Leadbetter talks about elementals kind of crafting plants, if you will, in the ether, kind of crafting nature, strangely enough.
So there's the, this is the direct line through, and on the floor again, the Vesica Pisces shape, in a way, the kind of flower of life shape coming out of here. And this has to do with Mozart, So you have sort of harmony and music in here, and Mozart was certainly aware of things occult. Mozart right here. So with the central pillar right here, and going up, there's the central pillar in the ceiling, and indeed you have, in a way, the triptych here, the three pillars within the lobby. Okay, down here there you have the Vesica Pisces within here. This is at the it's got the hotel in here. I think that's the Hyatt. There's also the Vesica Pisces, a couple of them here around the site of the towers here. So the towers have 88 floors to them. The height is 452 meters. There are 88 floors, and this flight deck floor is 370 meters high. Just to wrap things up with this video, so the height of the towers would be 452 meters high, which is close to 1,480 feet high, but certainly not exact. 148 is a measurement that can be seen in other buildings, I believe the Arc de Triomphe and so forth. But beyond that, the towers have 33,000 stainless steel panels, 55,000 glass panels. The glass panels make for 77,000 meters square. The design of the building is lotus-like, but really it's lotus-like. It's also two squares making the eight-pointed star. You also get 32 out of that, so you see 32 and 24, 8 within these buildings, based on Islamic design. The sky bridge spans the 41st and 42nd floor. The 42nd floor is a hermetic number also. So just pointing out a few of these things, there will be many more aspects to these towers. I hope you enjoyed the video.